Good morning, my dear darlings. How are you? I hope you are all doing very good. Welcome to the online classes of Sri Gokulam Public School. We are into yet another English class. So, in today's class, we are going to do a writing section. So, we have almost covered the portions for this month's literature and also we have done a bit of grammar. So, let us do a little bit of writing for today. And in today's class, we are going to discuss about something which is very, very important, that is letter writing. Now, you might be thinking, in today's generation, who writes letters? Of course, our technology has developed so much that now it is very easy to send emails or just WhatsApp for passing information or to know about our friends or relatives. But letter writing is also as much important in today's world, especially when you are writing formal letters. Now, what do you mean by formal letters? My dear children, let me just divide this letter writing into two parts, that is informal writing and formal writing. Now, informal letters mean the letters that you are sending to your friends, your relatives, your parents, etc. The language is very personal and you are writing to know about their well-being and also you are explaining to them about your well-being. So that is what informal letters are about. In olden times, letter writing was the only means of communication between people. But right now we know that the situation is not the same. So you can say that informal letter writing has become almost extinct-like. We do not use it at all. But formal letters are still now used. Now, what do you mean by formal letters? Formal letters are letters written for official purposes. In your school, you know that whenever you make a mistake, you write an apology letter. When you want a leave, you write a leave letter. When you want to apply for a TC or some other documents from the school, that also is officially informed through a letter. In the similar manner, for all office purposes, government purposes, also we are writing letters. So, formal letters or official letters are still now very much important because this is kept as record. That is why it is important. Now, letter writing has got a method or a format. There is very, very a strict way how you should write a letter. And based on that, you are going to get marks for your exam. In today's class, I am going to teach you about how to write a formal or an official letter. So, you have to be very alert and listen very carefully the format of the letter. Where to write what and what are the things to be included. These things have to be followed as it is without any change. So let's get started with today's class. All of you should be ready with the pen and paper. Quickly jot down the points what I am telling you. So let's get started, dears. So my children, I have just written down the format of the letter writing for you. Now let us go into the detailed explanation of how to write the letter. Now for your better understanding, I have drawn a line on the board. Okay. So this is to show to you that whenever you are writing the letter, towards the margin is how you will place or write your letter. Everything that is written is towards the margin. It is not in the middle or not on the right side. On the left side, margin is how you have to write your letter. Now, what is the first thing that you will write? The first thing to be written in a letter writing is the sender's address. Okay? Sender the sender? Sender is the person who is writing the letter. So when I am writing, I am the sender. When you are writing, you are the sender. So your address is what you will write first in the letter. What are the things to be included in the sender's address? Only two things to be included in the address, that is your house name or street name or house number, whatever it is. Okay, that and next line, the place of your stay. So here I have mentioned as Mayur Vihar Trishur. Okay, Mayur Vihar, my house name, and Trishur, my place. So you can put it as Rose Villa, Chittattugara, or Amina Manzil, Guruvayur, whatever it is. Okay. So this is your sender's address. Next, you have to leave a line. Leave a line over here and then write the date. Date. Date is the second part. How do you write the date? Always the date is written in the format, that is date, month and year. You should not write 16-10-2020. That is a wrong format. For official letters, the month has to come in full. So it is 16th October 2020 or 16 October 2020. Either way you can put it. Both are correct. Then what do? Then you again leave a line. Again you leave a line and then write the receiver's address. Receiver's address. Okay. Now, who is the receiver? Receiver is the person to whom you are writing the letter. If you are writing the letter to me, I am the receiver. Here, the receiver is the principal. So, we are writing a letter to the school. So, principal is the receiver. So, we are writing sir's address over here. Now, again, whenever you are writing the receiver's address, there should be three parts to it. First is the person whom you are writing the letter to, the principal, the class teacher, the vice principal, the administrative manager. Whoever you are writing the letter to, that person designation or name should be included over here. Then the name of the organization. If you are writing a letter to the government, then you will write Department of Tourism, Department of Health, okay, whatever, Police Department, wherever you are writing the letter to. So here we are writing the letter to the school, so it is Sri Gokulam Public School. And the third part is the place, which place this organization is included. Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur, Sri Gokulam Public School, Trishur, Sri Gokulam Public School, Calicut, whichever place you are writing the letter to, that place should be included. So again, three parts for the receiver's address: designation, organization and the place. Okay, then again you leave a line. You have to leave a line over here. Then you write the subject. Now what do you mean by subject? Subject is the content or what you are planning to write a letter on. So a brief of it. Brief means the short, important words of what you are expecting from that receiver is your subject. The subject should always be written in maximum 3 or 4 words only. 3 or 4 words only needs to be included over there. So you will write subject, put a colon and then write the reason for writing the letter. So here it is request for leave. So request for leave is the subject, which is the fourth part of your letter. So you will write the subject, then again you will leave a line and then is the salutation. Salutation means you are addressing the person. You can say dear sir, respected sir, or simply you can say sir. That is also enough. Then you leave a line. Is the content of the letter or the body of the letter is after paragraphs should be there. So, first paragraph is the introduction. All these three paragraphs should be starting from the margin. Okay. New paragraphs you will start from the margin. No need to start from the middle of the page. From the margin. First paragraph, you are introducing yourself and the reason for writing the letter. So, if I am writing the letter, I will say that I am Nida Subramanian. I am studying in 6th standard, in 6th A or 6th B or 6th C class. And I want to write a letter to request a leave from you. Okay. So, like that you will introduce the reason for writing the letter. Again, you need not elaborate it or write it in a very lengthy manner. Two or three sentences is enough for introducing the letter. Then, second paragraph. Your second paragraph is the explanation. Explanation is you are giving the details of why you require a leave. So, you can say that I require a leave because I want to attend a family function in Mumbai, or you can say that I am having a fever and a doctor has told that I should take 2 weeks rest. Any reason. The reason you are giving the details of it, again 2 to 3 sentences only needed for explanation. Then is the conclusion. Conclusion means the ending part of the letter, which is the third paragraph of your body of the letter. In the conclusion, you are going to thank your principal or the authority for reading the letter, and also you are going to mention there what kind of action you expect that person to take. Now you have requested for the leave, so what will you say? You will say that I hope, sir, that I will be granted leave. Together you can say 6 or 7 sentences. 2 sentences for your introduction, 2 sentences for your explanation, and 2 sentences for your conclusion. That is more than enough. Clear? So with that, your body of the letter is over. Then the last part, again you leave a line, and then is the closing. So closing is yours truly. You have to write yours truly and then write your name. So that is the closing of your letter. So this is what is included to be in your letter writing, formal letter writing. So first is sender's address. Second is date, third is receiver's address, fourth is subject, fifth is sanitation, sixth is content, which is 3 paragraphs of the body, and seventh is the closing. So these are the parts of your letter writing. I hope everything is very clear for you. I will give you one sample letter so that you can read through it and learn more about the formal letter writing. You have to study this format and remember it very well. Okay, click. Is it very clear, my children? 7 parts of the letter. Each part, when you start, you have to leave a line, and all the 7 parts starts from the left margin of your paper. And whenever you are writing the letter, you are not supposed to use personal language like hi, how are you, I hope you are doing good. Those kinds of personal languages are not required. Whatever you are writing should be very, very official, formal, and proper way of English should be used over there. So with this, I am concluding today's class. We will do more revision of this in our live classes. With any doubts that you have, you can ask me at that time. So study the format very well. Till we meet again, I hope you all have a wonderful time. Thank you and have a nice day.